Says that Jesus is the spring of the living well that can fill you up like nothing else can. Let me tell you something about worship. Maybe worship isn't just something that we do. Maybe worship isn't just something that we do. And the Bible, the Bible brings in worship and speaks on water, two completely different substances. But as I'm reading, I'm thinking maybe we're never really talking about water. Maybe we've never been talking about water this whole time. Maybe it's all about worship, Anthony. Maybe worship is what the Holy Spirit sits on. I said maybe worship is what the Holy Spirit sits on. Maybe worship is what brings in the Holy Spirit. Could you imagine what would happen if each and every person in this house, each and every person that got together today in this gym, would just lift your hands up for a few moments and start worshiping correctly? It wouldn't be safe for your affliction to be in this house this morning. It wouldn't be safe for depression to be in this gym this morning. It wouldn't be safe for a tumor to be in this house this morning. It wouldn't be safe for cancer to be in this place this morning. Let me tell you something. The Bible says that Hezekiah told God, Father, the grave cannot worship you. King Hezekiah was in his last days. And he turns to God and he says, God, he says, the grave cannot praise you. The Bible says that God told Hezekiah, if you start worshiping me correctly, I'll restore 15 years to your life. I don't know who I got in this place, but if you start worshiping God correctly, you'll restore whatever it is that you're going to be. Oh, really fast. We're about to move on. But everybody in this house, with every eye closed, I wouldn't look around right now, with every eye closed, just listen.